Well, hello, folks.
Oh, hi.
How we all doing this evening? How are you, Jello?
I'm first high. Foremost, how are you?
That's I anticipated that response.
Yeah.
Who do you have here?
I don't know, but she's saying it's about damn time.
I thought it was one of those cows on TikTok. She kind of looks like one of them.
She definitely looks like a cow.
There's that. What's up, folks? How's it going? I haven't done one of these in a couple of weeks, so I figured, you know what? Fuck it. What better time than now? Let's all rejoin. Right. Let's all rejoin. And let's see what kind of fuckery and debauchery has gone down. So I'll say this, just to go ahead and right off the bat, for anyone who would be like, you know what, I don't know what they're going to be taking a look at. I don't know if this is worth my time. I'll go ahead and let you know right now. Number one, probably not. Nope. But two, we're going to do some Crystal Station.
Damn it, I thought you were gonna say crystal meth.
Yeah. Well, you know, I don't want to bring a dark side to the stream, you know. I guess it depends.
Damn, it's gonna be a good stream and a long one.
Right. Random 24 hours.
Seventh hour, we're gonna start chewing on our own lips. It'll be great fun, folks. You'll love it. We're white knuckling this bitch.
As per usual. Who the fuck is... I don't even know who this is. Who is this? Oh, emo. Yeah, I do have some emo. It was kind of a vague title, which is what I have here on my little lineup. But yeah, I got some emo. We got a Dave video. This is another one that's kind of telling of Dave and his nature.
Oh, Christ. I hope it's nothing like we watched on Sunday. That was rough on me. I laughed so hard, I just about died.
It's not necessarily a race thing this time. Wasn't that the Sunday video we watched today, or was that the Saturday video? I can't keep up with.
I don't remember. I just remember laughing so hard that I was making these gasping sounds because I couldn't fucking breathe.
Oh, yeah.
And like, yeah. People were assuming that I got the hiccups. No, fuckers, I was dying. Actually, dying. I was thinking about actually quitting the geek room because, you know, bad for my health. But I was like, fuck,
more
it,
than
I don't
just
have
mental
much to live
now.
For anyway. So might as well keep going.
Jello powered through. I think everyone was having their own little conversations, and then we just kind of heard you die.
It was too much. So I don't even remember what it was, but it just about killed me. It was definitely during Dave.
Yeah, I do recall something like that. I don't, goddamn, I wish I could remember exactly what he said. I guess it was, I mean, I think it was the private show, though, so it was probably there for a reason.
Yeah, it's probably gone.
Oh, yeah, that's true. We did show, like, all of Emo's dick and ass on that stream, so it's probably not there anymore, but...
Yeah, it's probably gone.
if you're a TGR supporter, you'll have access to it if it's still there, but I bank that it's not. And who the fuck else do I have? I got some Cobes, and I have a smidgen. A bit of Von Helton, because he's kind of been hasn't been up to many shenanigans in the last few days. But I did catch something that was pretty lousy. So yeah, that's the docket, as G-Man would say, for tonight. That's what we're going to be taking a look at here. So
I don't know if you know this brand, but you got a couple of channel memberships during the intro.
I did. I also have a super chat to get to too. I'm fucking
okay,
slack.
Sorry, my bad.
Oh no, man, you're fucking fantastic, sir. Let's see. Where do we start? We'll start with Mango here at the top. Member for 10 months. Ill-advised, but appreciated nonetheless.
Poor choices, but thank you.
Yeah. We got Lady Starfire, member for 12 months. That's a full calendar year of mistakes. But
Lady Starfire asked me on the Friday show on Widow's Channel if I had ever been to a record store called Wax Trax. And it took me a minute. I'm like, I know that name. And I remembered it's not just a record store. It's a record label. And I went and looked up their discography. Some of my favorite music, a lot of my favorite music from the 80s and the 90s are Wax Trax. So if anybody's into, like production companies, they have a great discography.
Something to look into, folks. Who else did I have? I saw another one. Oh yeah, Philly Guy. Philly Guy just became a member. So Philly Guy, you're the first mistake of maybe just the one. I don't know. It just really depends on you. Yeah, but thank you, nonetheless, Philly Guy.
Yeah, if he's a smart guy, it'll be one and done.
Is he a smart fella or smart smella? We will find out. And of course, thank you. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Where is Mr. Conductor? Hell, Snickers. I don't know where the fuck Lil Bill is. Lil Bill's role on this show is pretty much just like he kind of fucking like Pennywise's it, you know? Just every 24 years he shows up or whatever the fuck.
If he's got nothing better to do, he'll stop by.
Yeah, it's very random, and it almost never. My notice of Billy coming on the show is, oh look, there's Billy. So, yeah, your guess is just as fucking good as mine. Has Mike died yet? No. We just we caught a look at that fucking cryptid Sunday, on the private stream. I would say he's very much alive, but I'll. Once again, I'll use the Rev quote. It ain't living, but you know what I mean.
Next thing.
All right. I'm going to, should we be democratic like we are here sometimes on the channel and let everyone vote on who we take a look at first?
Sure.
I mean, fuck, I don't have any like rhyme or reason to this shit anyway. So how about we do one for Crystal Station? Two for Emo, three for Dave. That's Lord of Patriarchy Dave, by the way. Four for Cobes, five for Vaughn. That'll work. I can count a little bit, so at least a five. And thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. At least with Jello here, the show will be funny.
Ah, thanks. But looks aren't everything, and I don't have my camera on, so we'll do the best we can.
God damn it, Jello. You motherfucker. All right. I see some numbers coming in here. 4, 4, 3, 1, 1. All right, it's
I think like a lot of people don't realize how Crystal funny Bran is because he's not like pounding people with jokes. I'm like a shotgun. I just throw a bunch of shit at the wall and see what sticks. Where Bran's like a sniper. Like he you know, takes time, holds his breath, count to 10, takes him a while to get a joke out, but when he does, it fucking kills.
I constantly have him. It's just a constant battle of, is this worth saying? And more often than not, it's like, nah, it isn't.
That's why I throw them all at the wall, because you never know.
Right? No, I've done it a time or two before. I've said some shit and just kind of winced and waited. But generally speaking, I don't. Fuck. All right. Who are we seeing more than anybody else? I'm supposed to be paying attention to this. I'm seeing a lot of fours. I think maybe more than anything else. So that was Cobra. So yeah, fuck it. I guess I'll go ahead and pull that up then.
So I was going to say, I honestly don't remember the order.
Yeah. The only reason I do is because I just said them in the order I have here on this list of videos.
That'll work. Yeah.
That's it. Otherwise, I probably would have been fucked too, and we'd all just be sitting here wondering why we're back at square one. All right, let's fucking do this, folks. Some more Cobra eviction complaints. Like you knew he would. So what are we thinking, folks? Is Jessica, does he believe Jessica's to blame? Is he to blame, accepting responsibility for herself? Or is it all of the trolls? I wonder. What could it be?
Unfortunately, I've already watched this video twice. I also grabbed this to play on the Friday show.
Oh, fuck. Well, you can't say anything, Jello. You're going to spoil it, as if most everyone else hasn't already watched it, too.
Everybody's watched this, I'm sure.
It's good shit. How can you
not? How do you not? This is this is wonderful. Seven greasy haired comb over coming in nicely
chilling out.
Seriously though, like that comment is kind of on point. Does it look like he's done a single thing since the initial I've been evicted stream? Like
no, including bathe. His fucking hair is greasy as shit.
Yeah, it's getting harder and harder to see though. So there's a plus for him. Eventually it's gonna be gone. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Bran is the least tistic of the TGR panel. That's holy shit. If I'm the least of the tism poll, that Jesus Christ.
Well, I think it's got to be one of us, either you or me. It's definitely not Billy or Frank for sure.
Well, yeah, I mean Billy's tism confirmed.
Way confirmed.
Like. A doctor, presumably not Sam, diagnosed him. And I only say presumably not Sam because I assume he's not that kind of a doctor.
He always says that. Ten a.m. moonshine.
Oh, no, that's what I fucking feel like.
On a Monday.
YouTube.
On a Monday.
He's kicking the week off. April
Fool's Day, and the only fools I see are the... Over
this morning.
Bro. YouTube trolls. Just chilling out like a rock star villain.
Tactical eviction. Holy shit.
Gonna wait for my Patreon money to come in and I'll do that.
I gotta say, monthly. Like, just the inclusion of the comments in these videos is one of the selling points of why I love Boglum Chronicles so much.
Boglum Chronicles is so good. My favorite thing about them is it cuts out the useless stuff.
Pew!
Because there's always gold in every 6 hour Cobra stream,
right? Just nobody wants to wade
through.
Who
wants to do all the mining?
No,
fucking like going, like watching a Boglum Chronicle video or there's a couple others I just have a hard time bringing to mind at the moment, but watching them is like going into a jewelry store and just buying a pendant. You know, it's like, here's my gold. It already looks like a cross and Jesus is hanging up on it and everything.
All pretty and nice, waiting right there with a bow on it. Not even just a re-upload, but, you know, making it, putting all the frilly little edges on it. Much, much appreciated, by the way. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Bet Sam only takes baths because, you know, yeah, I do know.
You think he's got like an aversion to, you know,
showers? Perhaps.
That was a great way to say it. I can tell you Sam would have loved that.
I think the last time someone made a joke in that same vein with that accent, I believe he said he had a shiver run down his spine. So I don't know. Who knows?
I used to greet him in that accent in a pretty nasty way that I'm certainly not
going
to
say live.
I used to do it all the time. And when I stopped doing it, he was like, why don't you do that anymore? he really liked it. And I can't, you know, run a joke to death. You know, I just, well, I mean, I can. I really can. I don't want to. My intent is not.
It's even better if it's a really good one and they want you to do it again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Leave them wanting more.
Yeah. That's
the rule. Leave them wanting more. Like, you know, definitely. It's better than playing it out.
Patreon shout outs. You're not going to see when I pack up or move or when I have to get out. That's none of your damn business.
Well, that's kind of the thing, isn't it, Cobes? Like, everything I know about you is none of my business. Like, that's kind of the point here. You make it everyone's business. Like, eventually, like, I'm sure at first you're gonna try to be like really guarded about your new location, but eventually you're gonna let something slip or show something. I mean, it always happens.
But then he's gonna blame his trolls for doxing him when it's right. Gonna be him doxing him damn self. Everything is the troll's fault. Don't accept responsibility for anything you do. Good job.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's and like you said, you've seen this video already. That's this video is a huge hammering home of that point.
It makes me mad when he like talks about how trolls. Look, I've been watching him since 2015, and as far as I know, he's only had two jobs.
So there was Wendy's and what else?
It was a bar and grill called The Office.
Oh fuck.
And I don't remember why he lost his job at The Office. I'll bet you there's someone in chat that can fucking refresh us. I'm sure someone still knows. But the Wendy's one, he was live streaming at home when he got the call from Wendy's saying, yeah. Where are you? And he forgot that he was on the schedule and they fired him right there. So, like, I mean, it's not just like he told his stream about it. Like, his stream watched it happen. It had nothing to do with calls they were getting from trolls. He actually, I hate to say this, but Cobes is a liar.
Yeah, yeah.
Cobes is one of the few of the cows that I actually like, but
yeah, he definitely has that, like, of everyone we watch, if you had to hang out and, like, spend a day with any of them, it's got to be Cobes. I know it sucks either way, but, like, I honestly feel like...
I can't imagine what he would smell like. I don't want to hang out with Cobes.
I don't know, man. I hear that goth guy smells really nice, actually.
I'd rather hang out with Sam.
Yeah.
That says a lot.
Well, if that chat from earlier is any indication, Sam hasn't had a shower either.
Go eat some boiled food with Sam.
Yeah. What a fucking date.
Sam, hold on.
Yeah, the Wendy's job was when he dyed his hair. Yes.
Oh, was that the infamous dye job? Or...
Yes.
Where is it?
Sorry, I'm not really great about reading chats. I can't read the chats on the Saturday show. I don't have the option. So, and that's the one I've been doing the longest. So I got used to just not. So I'm trying to do better. I'm trying to re-educate myself.
Yeah, sometimes I'm good at it, and then sometimes I kind of fall into the trap of like the conversation and just watching the video, and so I feel you. I fuck up there myself.
I mean, if you see me from across the street, you can guess that I'm not the kind of guy that's good at learning stuff.
Yeah. It will come, Jello, with time.
Sorry about that. I had to take a wicked shit, and I feel better after taking it.
Thank you.
What? And I also won the lottery. April Fools. See, I got a little bit of that in me, you know.
Bro, like, he really had me going there for a second. Like, I'm thinking Clock Tower Dream House coming in fucking hot. You know what I mean? Like, it's finally going to happen. Fuck. Then he hit me with that. I forgot what day it was, you know? That's really, you got me, Cobes. You got me. As if you wouldn't immediately have fired up a stream, first off, when you won the lottery, which is mistake numero uno. But he would.
For any fans of the Howard Stern show, Crazy Cabbie died on April 1st. That was kind of a tough one, but because of who it was and the kind of people that surrounded him, when you heard it on April 1st, you're like, did he really though?
Yeah, right. That's I'm sorry, objectively best day of the year to die.
Definitely.
Everyone's gonna question it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're lucky, you get like one of those conspiracy theory deaths from there going forward. You know, you get your Elvis or Tupac.
Oh, wouldn't that be great?
Right? You're basically eternal after that, you know?
Jello never died. He wanders the earth to this day, like Cain. That's what I once said about me after I died.
The Jellonites rise up.
I do hope I find Puff.
Wait, what? Okay, how long has it been since this motherfucker lost this thing? The whole winter, right?
Delusions are coming in nicely, Tubes.
Yeah, man, I'm sorry, man. There's about a 0.0% chance you ever see your little bearded buddy again.
Oh yeah, some animal ate him, and then some other animal ate the carcass. Long time ago.
Pretty much. It's not in the cards for you.
No, he's not under the sofa, Richard. He took off. He got out, and Cobes decided to take him for a walk outside the apartment.
As you do with a bearded dragon.
And the thing said, yeet.
I mean, can you blame the fucker though? Like,
the fucking Cobes is blowing pot smoke at him.
You can't.
He likes to get high, Tubes.
You're a bearded dragon. You're not thinking long term, like what you're gonna do when you get away. You just know you gotta get away.
Oh, dude, fucking highlight Fat Photog's second comment there. If you know, you know. That's some funny shit.
Oh man, how many apartments is this at this point? It's two or three.
This is number three, I believe.
Okay, I thought so. Oh man, is he gonna fucking like cut up his carpet again and sell that shit? Oh, I hope so. I missed out last time. I may have to buy a piece of history.
What was that? You can get banned from my channel. If you're going to talk shit on Ozzy Osbourne, you're going to get banned from my fucking channel. I'm not playing around. Ozzy Osbourne is like my John Lennon. You know what I'm saying? So you don't fucking say that crap.
Ozzy Osbourne is actually more coherent and in better shape than Cobes.
Yeah, and it's not even just an age thing, too. It's like the copious amounts of drugs and alcohol on top of that, and still somehow.
You can count the amount of brain cells that Ozzy has left on two hands.
Yeah, but he's still got a... Like, no, he's one of those dudes that no matter how, like, fucked he was, when it was performance time, it was just, okay, this is second nature. I can still do this if I can't do anything else. But Cobes here is the same way, you know? Even when he's, you know, here one moment, gone the next, he'll still be able to sound like a Backstreet Boy. And that's going to piss all the trolls off.
Why not? It's April Fool's, and I feel like tying one on.
When do you not?
Last week was not the best week for me, but this week's going to go a lot better. I got a good feeling about that.
It looks like he's drinking last night's piss jug.
Right, it really does, like... There was like, at one point in this video, I think it's we've already passed it, but it looked like there was actually something in it, like other than the liquid, something for floating.
Sure. Well, maybe it wasn't just a piss joke.
Yeah, apartment already cut his water off. It's awful.
He's got delusional ideas that fantasies that him and Jessica are going to have a house that's they're going to move into. He's going to move out of an apartment and into a house for him and Jessica. He's going to be a homeowner.
Huh.
Of course, no real plan. He's like, what is it, the underpants gnomes?
Oh, yeah, gotcha. So
first we move into a house. Then ...
Profit. Oh man, yeah. That's good. So the guy who has failed at being a renter, Bryce, is gonna become a homeowner. This oh man.
Well, the thing is, the only way he's ever gonna be able to hang on to his place while living with Jessica is if they doesn't have neighbors, because you can't make her stop. Let's see what Drew Lover had to say. You can't make her stop stomping or screaming.
Yeah. You definitely have to get like, something secluded, but that also works against you in the same vein, because you know, what if the screaming and stomping ends up with screaming and stomping on his head? Which I wouldn't rule out as a possibility at this point. So there's also good nobody to like, no neighbor to disrupt, but also no savior for whenever she finally starts throwing hands.
I don't know. I get
or an $8 machete.
This weird vibe off her that like I think she wants to get him to hit her. I don't know that she's violent. I think she wants to. I think her goal is to bring violence out of the other person.
So it's just it's a race to see who's gonna commit.
Oh well, he won't. He won't. He's way too non-confrontational.
Dude, he's spine-bustered warlord though. Like it's in him. There, it's in there somewhere.
Well, yeah. But I mean, she is female. Like I don't believe for a second that he'd hit a girl, even if she was hitting him.
I would like to think that that's the case, but I don't like for sure know that she couldn't get him to a point where he may.
I'd rather think that if someone's hitting him, he could, you know, defend himself, no matter who it was. That's what I'd rather think, but I just don't think he would.
Yeah.
Like, you don't hit women, but women don't hit men either. Once someone breaks that, all bets are off, right? Bitch hit me once. She ain't doing it again.
Oh, the smoky peach moonshine. Yeah, everybody gets go. Well. That is smooth. Like silk. What's up, brother? It's Diddy with you. Yeah, all right.
Oh, man, I was going to try to pause it on that face, but never mind. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. NAL's bathwater looks like split pea soup after.
Jesus.
Yeah, I noticed a yellowing the other day, and I never saw any kind of bath bomb or anything go in, so that was suspect.
I mean, to be fair, yeah. She might just have, like, rusty pipes.
I mean, yeah. I think my thing was like, and I could be wrong. You could be totally, you could be onto something. Like I said, I could be wrong, but I don't think the water looked that way at the beginning.
All right.
I could be wrong, but I think that was the thing that kind of struck me as I left and came back, and the water for sure had more of like a Simpson-y tint, shall we say.
My favorite NAL stream was my favorite NAL stream from Cobes's place was the one where they had the great fight in the kitchen where she was just trying to tell him that there was already bacon grease in the pan, right?
Yeah.
That was a great one. But the second of the two she had two bathtub streams like two nights in a row, and that second one where she's screaming at her dad, it was right before she came out to see Cobes.
Yeah, what did she even do?
Yeah, exactly. All she was trying to do was wash her face. Yeah. But her dad called her a cunt, and her mom told her not to come back. So it was a good night.
We're a happy family. We're a happy family. Me, mom, and daddy.
Sitting here in Queens, eating refried beans. We're in all the magazines, gulping down Thorazines. We ain't got no friends. Our troubles never end. The Christmas cards we send, Daddy likes men. It's a great song. I'm really proud of you. I had no clue you were a Ramones fan.
Oh, yeah. Some good stuff. It kind of starts with like I'm a horror movie fan, so there was my in.
Sure. They've been in a lot of their soundtracks for a lot of
right.
I mean, not even including Pet Sematary, right? Like you don't even have to go there. A lot of B-rate horror movies use the Ramones in their soundtracks.
Oh yeah, that's how I found a lot of music, like fucking Misfits, what is it, Ice Nine Kills. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Bet a gallon pours out when he stands up.
When she stands up.
Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, fuck you. That's gross. That's fucking disgusting. Well, what I mean,
she even do?
I guess that would be like where all that bathwater goes, right?
Fuck.
Fucking dad was on to something.
That correctly. Thank you for your donation, Hunter. I appreciate it. Now, all I can do is just keep a cool head about this whole situation. And keep doing my thing.
Don't they know it's illegal to admit someone with autism? You're a protected class.
I really like how he's like talking about looking at this with like a cool level head, you know?
Yeah, what does he care? He doesn't have to pay first and last month's rent. That's gonna right. be on Clint. In fact, Clint's gonna come and help him move. His sister probably will as well. He doesn't even have to pay for the gas. Like, he's good.
Fuck, man. He's Like,
he's fine.
Not that I necessarily would want to see like anyone just to be fucked over or whatever, but like sometimes people kind of need to just be dropped into the deep end. Like, bro, you gotta sink or swim at some point. Like,
he needs to. I mean, if you're gonna do that, well, then he also needs to experience real bullying too. Because him,
yeah, his definition is
I hate him being a cry bully. Like, it's getting really offensive.
Yeah, it gets to that point often with him. Like, there's that's kind of like the only time I roll my eyes and want to move on in a Cobes video is when we start hitting that, like, oh yeah, you guys are just messing with me because I'm autistic or some shit along those lines. Like, Jesus, the fuck out of here, dude. Come on, look at you.
Or by the 15th time he brings up how he's in the trolls' heads, that he lives rent-free in the trolls' heads.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't have to send them DoorDash, you know, to get in their head. He's already there.
He can't go a minute without thinking about the trolls. Talk about living rent-free in someone's head. Moo, you got something there. Here's the thing. I got a feeling that if she moves down here and moves in with him, I'll bet within getting kicked out of two more places, Clint will be like, look, if you're going to keep living with her, I'm not going to keep running you a new place every couple months.
So you think he's got two more?
I mean, he's quite the enabler.
Yeah,
I'd like to say this would be the last one, but I don't know. He's quite the enabler. I have a feeling that she could move on down and, or even come to visit and get him kicked out within a week, and then and it's crazy too how he could do fine for no matter how long, and then she comes there for a week, he gets evicted, and it's the troll's fault.
Yeah.
Like, you can't even consider for a moment that maybe...
Like, what's Occam's razor say here, Cobes? Like,
exactly. Like, you've had the same trolls the whole time.
Right. They don't want you evicted. They want to watch your antics in your apartment. Like, it's... If somebody was going to be malicious like that, they would have done it long ago.
Jilly's mom... what you're saying would make sense, but I don't think much in the Kroboverse actually makes sense. So
what happens when Clint does?
No, she said, I don't think Clint would pay rent if Jessica lived with Cobes. And I just, I think he will. I just think he will.
I learned a lot about Clint since that interview he did a few months back. And yeah, I don't think I've ever seen more of a coddling, enabling parent in my fucking life.
Well, if you have, it would be Shani's mom.
Yeah. See, I didn't know an awful lot about Betty. Only like the stuff that Shani would bring up, and we would all be like, oh, okay, here's, you know, Betty talking about that kind of shit. That was pretty much my only experience with her. He thinks Occam's Razor is a Cradle of Filth song. Yeah. Yeah. Shocking it's not, right?
Oh, yeah. If they keep living in apartments, they'll definitely get a domestic called on them, whether or not they're actually physically violent. She's going to be stomping around and throwing stuff around, and the neighbors are going to assume that, you know, they're duking it out.
Yeah, it's pretty inevitable, I would say, that those two living together, or even her visiting with any regularity, is not going to end well for him, especially. You got to get your back there, Cobes. You got to go travel to her place and get her kicked out. Now, her parents already like her. It should be fairly easy.
What Clint needs to do is suggest to Cobes that they just get Cobes a hooker every now and then. Because it's clear that Cobes is more interested in getting his dick wet than staying in an apartment.
Yeah. Yeah. Goddamn biological imperative wins again, huh, Cobes? You're gonna have to fucking stifle that thing, man. You know? We've seen the effects, at least what it did to your lip. There's no telling what it did down there.
Come on, people. You think Clint is going to let Cobes go homeless? That's going to take some doing. Cobes is going to have the chick that's getting him evicted living with him before Clint actually says no.
I mean, also, too, people, like, I saw it in chat earlier, like, what happens when Clint dies. It's like, are we really not taking into account that Cobes goes before Clint? Like, he's not exactly living the most healthiest of lives, to say the least.
Jilly's mom, he definitely wants her to live with him. Look, this isn't her fault in his mind. This is the troll's fault. The trolls called in a bunch of fake noise complaints, and that's why they got kicked. That's why, you know what? He's about to explain himself. I should just
look. Let's just say there was a troll who called that in. Even if they did, was it a fake like noise complaint? If there's actually noise going on in the apartment, I don't know. But you know, this is Cobes we're talking about here. It's
because of Jessica entirely. It's my YouTube trolls. They found out where I lived and they basically harassed this place.
Nonstop. They've known.
And yeah, just leave it at that.
That's true. He did say that.
She didn't exactly help either, but she's and I have. We have talked to each other and apologized. You know, when it comes to Jessica, I'd rather talk things out privately off camera and just hash it out.
Yeah, that's your style.
Like adults.
So him and Jessica apologizing to each other means that she's never going to scream at him again in the middle of the night, right? Is that what he's thinking?
Is that going to be a part of the peace treaty? Okay, well, she's going to read that very specifically and go, okay, you just said the middle of the night. So it's noon, bitch. Let's go.
Shannon, the only woman that can fix Cobes would be like a therapist. That's... like, people can't really fix each other, right? They just wind up getting codependent with somebody that's broken.
Yeah. Once again, see Shani and Rev.
There you go.
I had a girlfriend. They immediately started harassing Jessica. As soon as they find out where I live, I get harassed at the apartments that I live at. And it's kind of bullshit, but that's just the mentality of my asshole YouTube trolls. They don't want me to have a girlfriend or be in a place where I'm happy kind of thing. You know, it's just, it's sad to be honest. It just shows you that my trolls are so fucking miserable. They're probably still stuck in their mommy's basement. Or something, I don't know.
The only reason you're not living with your dad is because he pays your rent.
Yeah, like, you're not living with him because
this guy talking about people living in their mother's basement.
It's like your dad was like, "Nah, dude, I can't live with you, but I will make sure you have somewhere to live." That's something you never want to hear a parent say to you, like look. I get it, whatever, but you just not here. Like,
and anybody that wasn't around for it, when he got kicked out of his last place, which he blames on the trolls, he got kicked out of his last place because he was using spray paint inside his apartment a lot. And they gave him warnings, and finally they said, fuck you, get out. And as far as... her being bipolar, you know, she reminds me a lot of Shani. I wonder if she's borderline. I don't know. I'm not saying this is what she, I can't help but wonder. She really reminds me a lot of Shani.
Oh, shit. If that's the case, she's got far more than BPD. Everything, I think, except diabetes. Yes, that's correct.
Fucking YouTube trolls. Because your life has to be so goddamn miserable that an autistic person such as myself triggers you.
I don't think you trigger anybody, Cobes.
More than I love cobras. And I get bullied for it. And quite frankly, I'm sick of that, too.
Bullied.
I'd really like to kick him in his
nuts. Who the fuck bullies somebody for hating sickos? Like, the level of... It's just become a thing now where it's like, oh, bully cobra, ha 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 ha.
Imagine how good your life has been that you think... getting picked on over the internets is being bullied.
You think being bullied is something that could be ended with like pressing an off switch?
That's crazy, bro. That's really crazy. That's not the way bullying works.
Nah, usually it takes place in an environment that you have to be in.
Yeah, you can't get away. Like those motherfuckers that wait for you on your way to walking to school every morning.
Right.
Or the asshole that's in your class that will fuck with you as soon as that bell rings and you get out. Like that's how you get bullied. And usually it's a physical thing. It's not just a fucking calling you names kind of thing. Like that's most of what Cobes goes through. I would just call busting balls. The fucking deliveries he gets are kind of hilarious. Like, you know, and again, if you don't want people to send you stuff, don't tell them where the fuck you are.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, it's just like the shit that happens to him. Pretty much all of it is like the glitter bomb. You know, like this is all kind of, like you said, just ball busting shit. Like this isn't. None of this has been like serious attacks against him or anything like that.
No. And you know what though? Wait, he did get swatted.
Oh shit, did he? Okay, yeah, he did. Okay.
Well, Cal Productions, it's good to see you again, sir.
You fixed me, Jello.
I didn't fix. I gave him some good advice on a couple of occasions, which he usually can't take anyway. So, but it's not anymore your fault than it is mine. Like, people can't fix people. It doesn't work like that. You need someone to fix you. Go get a fucking therapist. You know, I know I can use one.
All right.
I laugh because it's that or cry. You know what I mean?
Laughing out of the assholes doing it. No one else thinks it's funny. They're like, wow, dude, what's your fucking problem? But I will get into a better place. It just sucks that I have to leave the conquistadors as I do thoroughly enjoy this apartment complex. I mean, a name drop like that, but I'm getting kicked out, so it doesn't matter. No, I didn't mean to just name drop like that, but, you know, I like living up here. It's a nice area, good people. I've never had any problems with my neighbors. I've always paid my rent on time, you know. So the only fucking issue, of course, would be my YouTube trolls pretending to be my neighbors, submitting customer complaints when there was none.
I love the detail here, like that this, whoever this person is, just have like Cobes' teeth at one point. And I have to say at one point, because they're still a little bit more functional here.
Submitting customer
crazy complaint. Now. Yeah. He's got the mouth of some fucking horror movie villain.
He does he's got a Jacob Goodnight mouth.
Look that shit one up. Front tooth that's busted off halfway and jagged, yeah. And the other black the other front tooth that has a big black spot right in the middle of it.
Yeah, that's easily avoidable too. He's got like a really like top-notch toothbrush, like the water pick and all that shit. Doesn't use it.
Rotten Ralph, well, saved that shit.
None to be had in the first place. And there's nothing you can do about it. There is nothing you can do about it.
To, you know, yes.
I appreciate everything that Daniel has done for me as a
woman. And now he's just a fucking... He's the mayor of Knox County, Tennessee, where... He's currently being a heel, if I'm not mistaken.
Landlord. He's one of the best landlords I've ever had. But you can only put up with so much, dude. And it's not fair to him. And it's certainly not fair to me. So what do you do?
Jessica actually spent about 10 or 15 minutes. I don't know if it was last night or the night before. But I, you know, catch parts of her stream. It gets really boring, and then I have to click off, and then I go back and check.
Same.
But at some point, she spent a while justifying how his breath doesn't stink and his mouth doesn't taste bad.
There's no fucking way.
I'm like, you have blown out your taste buds. Definitely.
There's no, like, oh, man, she's...
Just the stuff that he eats. Just this, even if he brushed just the stuff that he eats, his mouth must be horrible.
Dude, the thing is, like, we've seen a little bit too close, a little bit more than I'd like to see of what's lurking behind those lips. You can't tell me there's not all kinds of fuck, you just took the word right out of my mouth there, Fat Photog. Fucking halitosis going on in there. But this, the jalapeno killed all the halitosis. Don't worry about it. He's got it. Fuck me, man. Yeah, no, you miss me with that shit, Jessica.
Well, yeah, what exactly am I kicked out of the
really changed over the last year. Like, he does not look like just over the last year. And I'll tell you what, it's really
mead, bro.
Since he's been making his mead.
Yes, it's the massive amounts of sugar he's putting in this shit. It's
totally
honey.
It's so much. Hey,
you remember he drank that one like just after he made it.
The eggnog one. Yeah. The eggnog one. Someone finally got through to him and told him, dude, you cannot ferment eggnog.
It took like, multiple meetings.
It and it will kill you.
So no, the first time he was like, oh, I can't leave it out. Okay, I'll refrigerate it. And then someone else told him, hey, bro, it's not going to ferment in the fucking refrigerator. So he gulps it. The whole goddamn thing.
He just drank it down. He just sat there and there was, you know, like a whole bottle of honey. I think did he put chocolates in it? Like maybe Reese's peanut butter cups or something?
Seems like he did. And chocolate milk.
Not chocolate milk. It was eggnog.
I thought he added chocolate milk too. Or did no, it may have.
Eggnog and chocolate milk?
I think so.
Jesus.
I believe he did.
That's the new spectator sport. Making and drinking milk-based mead.
Yeah, so like any sane, rational human being, oh, I don't want to make this go to waste. I better drink this all right now. It was beat us in a bottle, and he polished that bitch off.
In one sitting. Yeah. In one sitting. Just sat down, turned on his camera, pushed the go live button, and just went to town complaining about how one of my fans told me that if I leave this to ferment, it could kill me. So I guess I'm going to have to drink it now, Tubes.
No, that's not what that means. Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah, you should have just thrown that shit away, my dude.
Like, chalk it up to a loss.
But then again, he should have thrown it all away. Like,
that's true.
He shouldn't have been drinking any of that shit.
Yeah, none of those atrocities.
His head looks like a fucking weird potato now.
Yeah, he's got like the golden eye DK big head mode going on now. Look at him. Oh, fuck. All right, folks, the first hour of the show is concluded now.
We're 7.5 minutes in.
I just noticed what time it was. I was like, oh, god damn it.
Hey, oh, what's up, cunts? yes, he did have chocolate milk in it.
I thought so. Christ,
that's awful.
Yeah, yeah, it made it worse.
All right, folks. So we're an hour in, so I'm going to let everyone decide. Do we want to keep with Cobes? Or do we want to have a wandering eye here? Look elsewhere. Yeah,
I could do hours on Cobes alone. I've been so enthralled with what's going on. The thing about Cobes that's so interesting to me right now
is
that I watched the whole Rev and Shani thing. And it's been really fascinating to see the downfall of a man boy, and the Cobes and Jessica saga is so reminiscent of Rev and Shani. I'm just like,
yeah, I thought fucking Nick and Sabella were gonna go down that path, but it looks like no, they've been ousted.
They're. She went and got a job, and who knows, he might too. And I think,
yeah, what the fuck,
try to pay for rent and stuff, and that's way different than, you know, Rev and Shani and Cobes and Jessica.
Yeah, they pulled a Yui. What did you write as me, you fuck face? Jessica did nothing wrong, it was 100% the trolls. Yeah, there you go, Cobes. You see that? That's full support. Now come on the channel for an interview.
Oh, that'd be nice, dude. I would be confused.
I wouldn't even really interview him. I would just shoot the shit with him.
I'd 100%.
Questions, but
no, there would be questions abound, but it wouldn't be.
Grampy Lobster was on some, I forget her name, but she has panels, and sometimes Cobes comes up, and also Cyrax sometimes comes up on her panel.
You mean panels?
Panel.
Well, anyway, if you know, you know. And anyway, Grampy Lobster was on one of her panels one day, and Cobes showed up, and Grampy was like, you know who would love to talk, and I was, and he knew I was in the chat. I was communicating in him through the side chat, with him through the side chat. And it's like, you know who would love to talk to Cobes, and you know, can my friend come in? And I'm like, no. And she's like, sure. And he's like, Jello, do you want to? I'm like, and it's hard to explain why Cobes is there, but Cobes to me is like something in a zoo. Like, I don't want to be at all hands-on with Cobes. I don't want to talk to him. I don't want to interview him. And
test subject? Do you just
want to... Well, that's how we've always, like, acted, though. We always treated it like keep hands and feet inside the ride at all times. Just point and laugh, folks.
Yeah. I mean, like, we've had a couple of these people on the channel, but we're not going to get involved in their shit.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, No. That's not what I mean, though. I don't want to have any kind of an interaction with Cobes. Like, because look, here's the thing. You can't give him advice. He's just going to accuse you of bullying him.
Fuck you.
Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Billy coming in late, bringing the show downs.
The downs always follow Billy around.
You get Billy?
Ha ha ha.
You get it?
Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha.
like the syndrome.
I hope your next hospital visit goes fucking well, fucking old man fuck.
No, Red Feather, I'm perfectly happy learning his hacks and watching his videos and even discussing them later. I just don't want to discuss it with him. I'd rather, you know, be behind my monitor shape shield. I don't have any interest in interviewing him by any means.
Better than a headstone shape one, right?
Exactly.
Thank you, Chubb, for the funny money. In that zoo, who's flinging the poo?
Yeah, all of us.
I think all of them, yeah.
The ones inside and the ones outside. Like, if you go to that zoo, you're probably a shit flinger yourself, right?
That's true, yeah. And, like, at certain point in times, like, certain ones of them, like, come out on top versus the other ones. It's really rare. It's weird.
Thank you, Silver, for the $5 super. I went back to the beginning, but I'm so glad you're streaming. I needed a laugh. These cows always give a good one. Appreciate that. But if you're glad that I'm streaming, I'm sorry that things didn't turn out better for you. Okay, so what are we gonna do here? Did you bring some for the whole class, Billy, or are you just bogarting it over there?
Depends. Jello, is there a dark side to crack?
I mean, not that I've found.
I think the U.S. government determined there was.
Wow, what do they know?
Call me it's crack.
Not like they put it there to begin with. Folks, where do we want to go from here? Okay, so we're gonna let democracy rule here. Once again,
I'm spreading democracy right now, killing bugs.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna spread those cheats later, Billy. One for Crystal Station.
Ooh,
that could be a thing. Two for Emo. Three for Dave. That's Lord of Patriarchy, Dave. Or four for Vaughn. Let's see, folks.
I'm feeling fucking Crystal Station.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Hooves.
She just killed a cat super recently. So
yeah. I love the criteria for how, like, who you want to see. Well, this one killed a cat recently, so
like, if pretty that's the case, pretty.
Why don't you want to go for Vaughn? He's killing dogs all the time.
Maybe, well, Billy should read this one since it's about him.
Read this one, little Bill.
Someday, Billy, you'll get old too. You'll have one foot in the grave and one foot in a jar on my coffee table. Fuck off, bugs.
Billy, you want a Snickers? Give me that foot, fatty.
I like how Jello's the one that's most excited about this, and he's the fattest one in the room.
When are you going to?
Stop trying to stab me. Stop trying to stab me.
I wanted to tell everybody that Billy has announced that for my birthday, he will do a topless stream on.
I will not.
Yeah, he will.
I will not. You would? No, absolutely not.
I'm seeing a lot of Dave. Lord,
you gotta be a bitch, Billy.
That's just how my mom raised me.
She raised you to be a bitch.
Apparently.
All right, I guess we're going to go Dave. I'm seeing a lot of threes. He was three, right? Yeah. Crystal was one. Emo was two. Dave was three. I feel
like it was rigged.
Yeah. I'll give it another. I don't see any more numbers coming. I think it's over there, little Bill. I think that's fucking
bullshit.
Fat Photog is exactly correct. Jello said it, so it's canon.
It's not canon. Jello can go fuck himself.
Much like Boba Fett being dead.
Who gives a shit what your fat ass says?
I love how Dave wins this vote, and now everyone's like, "Oh no, not Dave!" Like,
you fucking. Yeah, that's why I said it was rigged, buddy.
Rigged by who?
And
the Democrats. Wait.
Did you notice Frank's comment in there?
What did Frank say? Billy, do a topless stream.
No,
in his contract.
Billy, yeah, will gonna, do it.
I don't have a contract.
It's in your contract.
It is in your contract. You don't want to get sued.
Yeah,
I'm fine with getting sued. I can defeat any of you fucking poor motherfuckers in a lawsuit.
Nah, man, I think Frank's got you dead to rights, though. Like, you signed the contract.
No, I would sue him and just get $500. So we all know how this goes down. Frank is not good at suing.
Oh, man. I'm going to show up and put a camera in Frank's face on that day.
Oh, that'd be great. I really wish, you know, like I know what I would do in real life. I would hit him.
Oh, it would have been so hard not to.
But seeing it, seeing it afterwards, like being Frank's friend and stuff like that, I would have hit the dude. But like now, like I can't do anything about it. It's just really funny to me.
I thought you were talking about you would have hit Frank.
No, it was like,
because at first I was like, you better. And I was like, well, no, I could see that.
Yeah, like the guy was like anti-Frank and like was like yelling at him, saying he was like a woman abuser or something.
Was that me?
No, some weirdo. Like that dude looks like he had like the most like weird face. I don't remember. There was something wrong with him.
Sounding a lot more like me.
That's true.
Weird face. Something wrong with him. Hmm. Could also be said of Crystal.
Review right now. Hopefully no one ruins this video like they always do.
You got it uploaded to our channel? That's my favorite video. I need to watch that more often.
No, bowling some, don't hate and don't judge. People don't get who I am either.
No bowling.
I'm autism. People let me think I'm gay when I'm not. You bet. You're not sleeping.
Jesus Christ, thank you.
There's nowhere to put the phone to let you know. There's not.
Work.
I'm not moving my fan away from the phone because there's nowhere to put the damn phone. I can try to.
So how do you buy... How do you buy everything at Walmart, but not a single phone stand?
Yeah, I'm sure they got their own brand of shit that's cheap, don't they? Like
On or something yeah. But no, but even then, like she probably has an iPhone. Those motherfuckers are magnetic on the back.
It's like Corky with the lapel mic. These fuckers just can't figure out.
Dude, one time I told him he did it right and he got mad at me and then fucking moved it.
Fuck you.
And I was like, dude, I wasn't being sarcastic. I get it. You would think for me. And most likely it was probably me being a dick. I understand that. But like, you got that shit right, dude. Kudos.
Fucking Corky went full on Rage Against the Machine on your ass, Billy. Fuck you. I won't do what you tell me. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Carrie hit kids like Billy hits the gym hard and often.
Oh, that's a compliment. Thank you,
Hooves. I was about to say, did someone hack Hooves?
Yeah, I don't like that.
I like that one.
I figured you were going to say Carrie hits kid. Well, there's a Frank joke that I'm not going to utter unless it was a private show, but that's where I thought you were headed.
Yeah, you should have brought Frank into that one instead of Billy, because there's definitely humor there.
Boo, Billy compliment. Boo.
That was my favorite super chat of the month. It was nice about me.
Didn't though I had to say. That's why I'm buying a tripod when I get paid, then it won't be like this no more.
Oh, look, she's talking about that. Paid by whom? Oh, yeah, doesn't she have a job?
Is it the hostess?
No. A hostess cake.
What the fuck is a hostess cake? I know a hostess. It's
made by that company that makes the Lacreen cheese.
Or Lacreen cheese or a Nestle chocolate.
Is this how you feel being like Italian where everyone like says your words fucked up? Like gabagool. Is that like
gabagool?
That's what's going on, but with like just regular white trash food?
I think so. Like she's like.
You think she would be able to get that shit right because you know white trash?
She seems like she would know Hostess.
Hey, like, oh yeah, you think she would be on the board of directors?
Well, I mean, that would be like Shana being on the board of directors for DoorDash. Just because you've spent a lot with them doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, you bought in.
Ooh, Billy should read this super chat as well.
I'm trying not to get killed by a charger at the moment.
That's okay. We can wait.
It's going to take a minute. I don't have guns that really pierce armor very well. They only have like one weak spot. Someone else read it. Snyder Banks' kids, his kids like Frank. That's all.
Thank you.
That's true. Frank does bang kids.
Yeah, but not his own.
Not his own.
Mm-hmm. Jesus Christ.
That'd be weird.
Yeah. Maybe even gay by Vaughn rules.
That is my favorite joke line we've ever told. Mainly because no one has ever fucking freaked out about it.
Well, Vaughn's...
What was that?
I don't know. It's part of this video. Vaughn's kind of the dude that you... I guess we can get away with that shit the most with, because like the whole banging his dying mom thing, no one really... No one even really questions that one is the funny thing, like the legitimacy of it.
And also, like, not that it matters, but Vaughn tries so hard to not see what people are saying about him.
And tried so hard to fuck his dying mom.
Yeah, that was one of the few things he actually did. He applied himself and he pulled it off.
I'm proud of him. Said no one ever.
Nah, fuck that. I'm clipping that. Billy's proud of someone for banging their dying mom.
One small leap for Vaughn, one giant spooch in his dead mom.
Twinkie. Another one.
Well, tell me the other day, Cupcake got a new Twinkie coming out. It's a bad motherfucker. When you bite into a cream fill and shoot all of your mouth, glitter.
Okay, I don't know what that's from, but cool, thank you.
I don't know what it's from, but I love it, and I need to see the whole thing.
It's delicious. Yes, Grandpa does like it, but I don't think this is Grandpa. I just know who is this now. Keith, is this you? Me and Crystal... And Grandpa, me and Chris Grandpa. Grandpa ate the older ones all the time. I mean, the old Keith, this is
Jeez,
you,
us Christ, who's?
Look at that. Look at that. That's art right there. Thank you, Hubs, for the $2 super. Fun fact, Vaughn wasn't a Diddy fan till this week. You know he's combing through his catalog on Spotify right now.
Maybe he doesn't have Spotify.
Free version.
Yeah, no, dude. He's on Pandora.
Oh, you think?
You think he's old? Old as fuck. Yeah.
I think he's listening to music on his Roku, like some random Roku app. That's what I'm going for.
I thought you were gonna be like a dick, like my uncle, and say on a Zune, because I like the Zunes.
I see Vaughn still rocking something like an MP3 player, though.
I loved my Zune, man. It's the first time I told nerdy that my uncle was going to do, and he's like, oh, you get your Zune? I was like, told you.
There you go, Shannon, LimeWire. Shannon's clearly an old head.
Yeah, LimeWire.
Does LimeWire still exist?
I wouldn't even know.
I would.
I used to love it back in the day. Along with ICQ and Winamp.
Dude, wait. Do you remember that fucking one song DRM? It's like, I'm looking at you through the glass. I don't know how much time has passed. I don't know if you remember. Do you remember the fucking DRM in that fucking song?
No.
Because there was that part where it's like, and the damn Republicans or whatever the fucking bullshit. And there's like a high pitched. Like noise that just ear raped you, like to the point where on LimeWire, like we turned it down a bit, was like the selling download.
Yeah, so many people giving their computer all kinds of viruses with like Kazaa and LimeWire, BearShare. Like there were a million of those fucking things.
Dude, my younger brother had one of those, like, you know those like little like bitch laptops they made back in the day, like the super tiny ones.
Yeah.
he had one of those, and he had so many fucking viruses on it to the point if you opened up an antivirus website, it would close it.
No, thank you.
Wow.
I was like, I didn't know they could do this, because this is way back in the day before I knew like half that shit now. I was like, God damn. And then apparently some companies started making their antiviruses open up as an image file just to confuse it.
Thank you, Hyan, Han, Hyan. I got to roll through all of them. For the $2
super. Hyan! Hyan!
Vaughn's a big fan of the Amish oil change. That's a horse joke, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's disgusting.
Most likely jerking off a horse. if I'm guessing what the joke was leading there, context clues, something to something, whacking off a horse.
Whackety schmackety horse.
Gross. Their cocks are big. Oh, you went a different way.
Thank you, Hooves.
There are.
Super. They hand out Zunes at the Special Olympics.
Thanks, buddy. I
go ahead and hit him with the line, Billy. You know you want to use it.
Just tell him you know.
Dude, I'm really good, man.
Nah, man. You know what you want to say, what everyone said back in the day when they came out.
I beat the shit out of all those retards?
No, they were like, Obama got a Zune.
Oh, I didn't know that one.
Yeah, that's,
I didn't know what I'm... Okay, so like at the time, I didn't like Obama.
Oh, yeah, that's right. This is even pre-Ben Carson.
Yeah, this is pre-Ben Carson. And on top of that, it was at the time I was in the military. I was signed up for the Navy, so of course I pushed for McCain.
Yeah.
He was a Navy vet. And the last... And one of the last good Republicans to ever run for president.
I thought that was Ben Carson, Billy.
No, no, no. I was wrong about that.
Word.
That was the last ditch of my baptism coming out there.
Yeah. Grandmother Jorgensen, not grandpa. You mean grandma?
I'm glad you didn't mean back then either.
Watch me now from the dead.
Fuck. Leslie! I'm glad none of you knew you back then.
Grandma's talked to me on YouTube live.
Wait, what?
You're telling me grandma's on here watching me now from the dead? Leslie! You can't hear me. Grandma's talked to me on YouTube live.
I thought I misheard that.
Dude, it's like that one time I joined Rev chat as who was that? Jared Leto with none of the names capitalized at all. And he's like, oh, Jared Leto's in my chat. And Shane's like, no, he's not. And he goes, he could be.
It might be really him.
Yeah, give me a job in Hollywood, Jared.
So if you thought Rev was the dumbest fuck on the internet, let me introduce you to Crystal, who now thinks her dead grandmother is joining her on YouTube Live in the chat.
Well, Rev also thought I was making four winged chickens.
Do you two have any clue how many A-list celebrities that Perry Caravello thinks are in his audience?
Oh, yeah.
He thinks Elon Musk watches him. He thinks Elon Musk is going to help him out with a lawsuit.
Also Bruce Willis.
Bruce Willis.
The Bruce Willis one's the most sad one because someone just fucking sends some super chats going beep, boop, bop, boop, beep. Boop, bop, boop, boop, beep. And I'm like, God damn, that's depressing because I actually really like Bruce Willis.
It's the funniest
that's
fucking
fucked joke. Up.
Meep, moop, clingy, dingy.
Bruce, come on, get some help, buddy.
Not the foot, Bruce, either. You don't get help. You keep going down the path you are.
Fuck you, bitch.
But he's still not him. So don't worry about it.
Grandma is. Yes, that's why I said no, not grandpa. It's grandma. That's what Keith says, isn't it? Because why? It says James. It's grandpa. It's Keith made on YouTube live a fake grandpa. The hell, Keith? You need help, bad. Yeah, she's watching. I know that. And heaven, I'm turning this off because I can't hear nothing at all. Now I need something like to drink. So nasty because it's
Yeah, he's demented as fuck.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Bruce Willis is, his brain is fucking gone.
Yeah.
Same with Bruce Shepard.
Yeah. Only, I don't think Bruce Shepard ever really had full, like, use of his brain. It's not like some debilitating illness. It's just he's a dumb fuck. That's all that is, so. Don't feel bad for the latter.
No. And on top of that, Sabella's doing better without you. There. With Corky.
God damn it.
His nickname is Retard. And doing better. Is that a rolling joke on you? Like,
well, dude, it's triggering him so bad. He's made like 14 channels that he can all like. He uses them to like up his videos and comment in the videos, and you can just tell it's him. It's the same four accounts.
Is anybody watching them?
No.
His accounts. Him.
No, but I mean, is there anybody else watching his?
No.
No.
Then what's the point?
He's a fucking psycho.
That's the point.
He's a lunatic, my guy. It's a, there's a descent happening.
Psycho way now.
Whoa.
Come on. Leslie's weird. Let me call Grump and see if he does or not. I don't know if this is true or not. I was going to eat my food. I can wait.
Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Brand Bruce's, you know, like Billy, foot and all.
No, he's way more diabetic than I am, buddy. Like, if he was on the diabetic Olympics, man, he'd be on the gold team, buddy.
Yeah, I'd say Bruce is like Billy, but more so.
Like a more profound Billy. What the fuck does that even
mean?
He's more like, profoundly Billy.
Yeah,
like profoundly play catch with a toaster in the bathtub, you fucking assholes.
All those things that make you Billy, he's just more of that.
Jello, you're literally the fattest person on this panel right now.
Good looking panel.
Oh, Crystal's here.
She's not in the panel.
Not in the panel.
Have a good night, Shannon. How can
that be possible? You have a plug where you live, but I will find out.
I will find out.
Right now. See what the hell's going on. Hello? Grandpa, are you okay? Yeah, I'm okay. Your oxygen ran out. It says I need an ambulance, but my oxygen tank has ran out.
Jesus Christ.
Now, this person on YouTube Live is saying his oxygen ran out.
Oh my God. Someone on YouTube is telling you this. Oh my fucking Christ.
Bro, dude. I think I just saw what we have to do. We have to tell her that her grandpa's hiding drugs up his ass.
No, she already gave him the death Dorito, dude.
Oh man.
Which I that's why I still contend is like attempted murder.
Yeah, way more so than Vaughn was utilizing most recently.
Grandpa, it says grandma. Well, someone made a YouTube on my YouTube Live, and they're saying it's their grandma. More
oxygen in this flask.
Yeah, for real.
I don't know if you read that, but Hood says, at Billy, that's because I don't have your address. Otherwise, you would have a pallet of ice cream Snickers.
Well, that would be fucked up.
That'd be fucking hilarious.
Who said that?
Awful. Oh,
fuck.
Yeah.
Oof, someone that's capable of actually doing it.
You're a dick.
Don't worry, Billy. I know you don't want no one having your address. I won't give it out.
Although that's the most terrifying sense Jello's ever said.
If you were going to dox Billy, two Hooves in order to have him send ice cream would be a good reason.
If you hate me.
Yeah.
Well, dude, you imagine. So like,
and want me to die in the most ironic way ever? Like, how many times have I made fun of people with diabetes?
Right.
Bro, you know what it's like having five of those bitches in your freezer. Can you imagine, like, having...
A palatful? No, dude. That's just a daily occurrence of, like, two.
And you got to eat them fast, too, because you can't pallet an entire, like, refrigerate an entire pallet of these
things.
Oh,
yeah. I'm going to have to go get a freezer.
Uh-oh, power went out. Better eat all the ice cream.
I'm pretty sure this is a Billy at the fucking goddamn generator, or at the fucking goddamn switch box. Click. Ah, now I have to eat them.
Oh, no.
Dude, okay, no, Lamar. Okay, Billy doesn't just like Snickers ice cream. The whole entire world does.
It's true.
If you bite into them and you hate them, you are a communist.
Billy and I disagree on a lot.
That's Lamorty.
I don't fucking know how to say his fucking shitty fucking name.
You were right, Bill. You were right.
You were totally right. I was being stupid.
I don't know, but I still got a shout out to call someone else's name stupid. I'm fine with it. Don't watch us.
The little devil.
I know you buy three boxes at a time. You sent me a picture of it. And why I was like, dude.
He's such a bastard.
Oh, those are some balls you got there, Hooves, buying three boxes at a time and intending to keep both feet. That's crazy.
Oh, dude.
Tank has ran out. You're talking to the fake grandpa on the phone. It's the devil.
This is the face of stupid.
This is the face of fucking. Did I actually call the fucking devil?
How did I get Satan's number? That's the most gullible bitch on YouTube. Holy shit. Leslie, my grandma's talking to me on YouTube. Never mind the fact she died. Oh my god, this is... Do more.
Who the fuck is this?
Just a random YouTube troll fucking with you.
What does she not understand about that?
With the home? Yeah, I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Maybe. Satan. Not today, Satan.
I get barm. No, it's not the fake grand. And I'm talking to my real grandpa, James William Jorgensen.
Good. I'm glad we have his full name. You know what else we need? His fucking social.
No, grandpa, you're gone.
And the three wacky numbers on the back of his credit card.
Also, the first 12, too. Or is it 12 or 16? I think 16.
I took a pill last night.
Yeah.
I love anything that's Chinese.
I love that she just doxed her grandpa. Jesus fuck.
Dude, she doxes everyone in her life, dude. I was like, remember that one time I had that neighbor named Stephen Smith? And you're like,
she would have known a middle name, too.
Oh, yeah, she would have put out a middle name, but I was like, because in my brain, I'm like, don't say someone's real name, is when I was talking. So I didn't focus on a middle name.
Actually, with what she's doing here, she's proving she's more intelligent than Billy.
No, she just eating proves broccoli. That she yeah. eats broccoli.
That proves that she's more regular than you, Billy. She's
No, dude, I drink supplements, dude. I'm good.
Yeah. He takes his little what are those things? Those gummy greens.
No. I have vitamin pack now that I take. And then I also have greens by Ghost. They make a green supplement and you shake up and then you drink.
I wish Jessica would give you a whole bottle of vitamins.
You gotta take them all at once.
Exactly. No, because then I would fucking die.
Right. Die of happiness at how many vitamins you have.
Based on the ungodly things she's done to Cope since he's been taking them, I am out.
Oh, come on. After the eviction, it really smooths out.
You can't get me evicted. I own this pitch.
thank you. Hyan, Han, Hyan.
Hi, Han.
Han?
Hyan, get new, Chaba.
For the $5 super. She's got the phone number of Satan. That doesn't beat Vaughn's Rolodex of Confederate slave owners.
Okay.
That's some good Von Hilton lore there.
Speaking about Confederates, I was listening to Philip DeFranco today, because I typically do every day. He was talking about a guy, because I like random news bullshit. He was talking about a guy who just got arrested for being the king of a monkey torture ring.
Why?
Apparently, dude, in like the one of those, I think it was like Indonesia, one of those, you know, one of those countries where like they steal your fucking like sunglasses and shit, and you have to bribe them to get your shit back in one of those places.
Oh, yeah.
Like, yeah, like they were like beat the shit out of them, or like they were like ordering like what Matt Bell did to kids, but to monkeys, except for like one of them they threw in a fucking blender, apparently.
Jesus. Bro, what the fuck?
Yeah, dude, that's a thing. And the best part is that dude who's the king of it was fat. Well, he's in America. His fat ass is standing in front of a Confederate flag picture and is fucking arrested.
Oh my God.
So there's definitely like links to racism,
probably.
God, that that's somehow makes it worse.
Yeah, and that's crazy that it would, right? But it does.
Dude, his name was like King Monkey Beater or something. Like it was like he was like fuck. Like he was like the leader, ringleader of beating the fuck out of monkeys for money.
Bro,
he was Andrew Tate of monkey beating.
Like, I want to make jokes, but it just seems so horribly inappropriate.
Yeah,
like, I'm sitting here rubbing my forehead raw right now. I don't
know.
Wait, Joe. We
topics, or I'm gonna
Joe, I'm rubbing one out.
Joe, oh, I bet some people were to those videos. Joe, real quick, would you rather be in a dryer or in a blender?
Oh, stop. I don't like thinking about people hurting animals. It makes me really upset.
I pick dryer. No, blender. This is like instant.
Maybe.
Yeah, I'm pretty fucking fat.
What if your bones clog up the
like your leg? Yeah, that would fucking suck. Like, I'm swan diving into that bitch. Like, if I know I'm getting fucking blundered, I'm just head first.
Blendered. Thank you, Loves, for the $2
super. Blender feller.
I would DoorDash a box a day. A1C coming in nicely. That's what's up, Tubes. That's
most definitely what's up.
Dude, if you sent me a box of fucking Snickers bar a fucking day, you're a cunt.
Of the highest proportion, too, because like you're instead of sending them all at once, you're paying separate fucking order fees.
He is keeping my economy going, though, for those dashers.
It's true.
Who are getting fucking royally fucked over by a massive corporation.
It is true. And I mean, they need help right now. The Shanty and Rev are broke.
Could you imagine, like they probably had like 401ks in Boulder.
Bro, they had to have seen like the downward trend of their services in that area.
It must have been like what happened in like early YouTube with PewDiePie saying the N-word randomly. But for dashers.
I don't know why that comparison actually works, but it does.
It's spot on, buddy.
It's fucking stupid as shit, but it works. All right. God damn it. All right, let's watch Billy's Worst Nightmare.
Your mom got him. Boy.
I'm only eating this today. But I'm gonna
if die. She had a vegetable.
It's all soggy because of the water.
I mean, she lives. She basically lives with one.
That's true. Oh,
dude, did you know that dude's like 4 years younger than me, Jello?
Leslie?
Leslie's 32.
Dude, he's bald as fuck, and his grill's all fucking doing things. Yeah,
dude, apparently he's 32. He just turned 32.
I mean, isn't it clear he's got some genetic issues going on?
Oh, it's very clear. But Jesus Christ, like, how do you do that in only 32 years?
I've been thinking about that whole...
Him and Cobes are aging like milk.
I wonder if he uses "I don't understand" as a way of getting out of stuff.
Either way, it's hilarious.
It is hilarious. It's definitely hilarious. But I just can't help but wonder, like, the whole "I don't understand tea" thing. What do you mean you don't understand tea? I think what he meant was he doesn't understand how to make it. Like, because she wanted him to make her tea. And I think that's how he does the lazy thing. I think that's how he got out of ever learning to read. When
I don't understand reading.
Do homework. I don't understand.
No, I don't understand this backwards three. You mean E?
See, I don't understand. You know that. And then his mom found out from a YouTube troll. High school? Oh, god damn.
Yeah, that's... by the time he was 18 and out of high school, he was like, he had just the old man stripe around the back.
That's rough. Yeah, I don't know, man. It seems like when I look back on people that were like around my age and generations past, it looks like people aren't aging as quickly as they used to.
He had alopecia. Thing is, he looked really good bald. He just started shaving his head, and he looked really, he had a good head. You know what he looked like? Did you ever see Barry?
The show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Fonzie of that show. I forget what his name was. But
Joseph Fonzarelli.
He was like a, he had alopecia, and he was really pale. Almost looked albino. The comic relief part of that show.
Yeah, I don't remember his name either.
But he looked like that dude. He looked like that dude. Like his head was like great for being bald.
Well, that's what happened with the guy from Blue's Clues too. He went bald really young. And then The fucking internet, though, like the rumor mill about that motherfucker after, like, he was going bald, everyone's like, oh, he's a pedo.
Good night, Joy Lover.
Nighty night.
I forgot about Aloha Pizza.
Aloha Pizza.
From the top of her loud.
That was a shantyism, wasn't it?
It was. Yeah. It was a good one.
We should make an index.
Dude, I'm going to tell you what I thought about the other day. I want someone to put together. They already put that together. And probably like a county over for me is where it came from. I'm definitely not going to do it because it's way too much work. But like, I want the full Shanny and Rev, like a bridge story, like all the high points in one video.
Like a Turkey Tom video?
Yeah, I guess so.
Because you know, if a Turkey Tom video happens, like, we're probably going to be involved.
Seems like a long video.
That's why I say abridged, because there's so much, but like, I just want really the high points. I mean, you
really
can sprinkle
feel like
things
that'll
in
be
there.
A four parter.
I'm fine with that.
Isn't the high point of him kicking the kid?
I mean, that's pretty much when things start. Going around the drain there, like,
well, for those people, low points are high points.
For the kid, it was a high point. It got the fuck out of there.
Yeah, permanent vacation.
So have you been keeping with the Vaughn shit?
There hasn't been a whole lot recently.
But his lawsuit and shit like that with like trying to get his estate back to him.
I know he filed in the wrong place.
But have you heard his the gist of his argument of why he thinks he should get it back?
Well, has there been some sort of an update to that?
Well, the gist is that he you can't give it to my kids because they're adopted out.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Which they are adopted out.
Yeah. Which, what, a couple of months ago, he was screaming they were not.
Yeah. Whatever helps him at the time, you know?
Yeah. Look at her go.
Either the cheap-ass Dollar Tree meals. 7 out of
10. Dude, that's Dollar Tree fucking goddamn fucking broccoli.
I'm really impressed, though. When she pulled out that tub, I was sure she was just going to eat, sit there and eat ice cream.
I would say Billy normally... no need to fear the veggies, but in this case, after that point you just made, yeah, okay, I'm on your side this time.
It's Dollar Tree broccoli, buddy.
Don't eat the Dollar Tree broccoli.
And that's terrifying.
You know what I would eat if I saw in the Dollar Tree, though? Snickers ice cream bars.
Yeah, because that's factory sealed, and it's like coming from like a reputable factory.
The stuff she had is sealed, too.
Yeah, but like, you know, they cut some corners with their fucking broccoli. Like, this one only had 7 right. bugs on it. We can give it to fucking Dollar Tree.
It's the meat in there. You probably really got to worry.
Oh yeah,
about,
there was though. Meat in there.
Yeah, it's I think it's beef and broccoli.
Oh, fucking beef adjacent.
Yeah,
I think it's like chicken stir fry.
Oh, is it like a? Is it
seems
chicken
like deal? There's more than just broccoli in there.
And stir Friday?
The meat was like lighter colored.
Oh, gross.
Is it stir Friday?
And La Morty, I believe Vaughn would still rage, but I also believe that he insulates himself to keep away from people that say things that make him angry. Or, you know, the truth.
J-Dubs.
He hangs around with J-Dubs, and he'll hang out with Solar, and there's another dude he'll hang out with. But, you know,
does Solar not call him on his shit from time to time?
No. Solar's learned that the only way to be able to hang out with Vaughn, he thinks Vaughn's hilarious.
Yeah.
He knows the only way you can hang out with Vaughn is if you feed Vaughn's ego and shit.
Oh, that's sad. I kind of like the random Solar going, hey, wait a minute, that kind of sounds like bullshit.
Oh yeah, like when Solar woke up.
Yeah,
it's pretty rare. He'll do stuff like that, but it's not very often. Usually, he just fucking feeds into Vaughn's bullshit.
It's unfortunate.
Thai food, I guess, you mix together. That's why it tastes like the way it does.
Yeah, that is like some kind of chicken or something, which isn't any better.
I might do that not today. You might get paid for each sticker from TikTok. Them stickers, you get paid on YouTube Lives to let you know. How many will that be for each sticker from TikTok? I don't know. A lot of money. First thing I'm going to when I get paid is IHOP. A group with like the eggplants. I like eggplants too. I'm healthy, right?
Thank you to the taxpayers of Michigan for this IHOP meal that we are about to receive.
Grandpa's not real. That I removed it from the YouTube Live. Grandpa, I just talked to. What I'm talking to is not the devil. That could be Keith doing it the whole time. I don't know who it is.
Satan.
We'll find out. Keith needs
to. That's some real fatty shit that I don't even do, man. What? Like sitting there eating, dreaming about what kind of food you're going to buy when you get
money. Next? Yeah. Like, oh, this next meal is going to be way better than this one.
I got
dollar store broccoli and got shit on IHOP.
It's crazy. Floor chicken.
Yeah, man. You're making the gross food even worse, fantasizing about something you want, though.
I have spring
floor good, yeah. chicken. Frank, what the fuck are you doing?
Hey, Billy, would you read Frank's message there?
Is that the X-Men theme in Dada's? Is that what you're doing? I don't know.
Frank, I think you had a stroke. If so, don't call anyone.
Wow, you're right.
Is that really what it is? Because that's where my brain went. Oh, shit, it is.
Dude, you're really good. As soon as you like read it like that, I was like, oh, my God, that's it.
Frank, were you allowed to watch the original X-Men when it released?
That's a good question.
What, did you like grow up Mormon or something?
He wasn't allowed to play fucking Mortal Kombat, dude.
Well, X-Men was on Fox Kids, so it was probably rated like G.
I don't know, but like...
Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. Billy's got Crystal's body in Leslie's hairline.
Okay, I like that one super chat he had like 4 ago.
I like how he let it simmer for a while, too.
Oh, and one of their IQ divided by the other one.
Yeah.
Hey, Jello.
Yeah.
You live in your mom's garage, bitch. Fuck you.
You do have a point there.
I don't understand vegetables. You know that.
I don't understand mortgages. Don't forget, it's a tradition too. If your mom randomly dies, you know what you got to do.
We laugh, but it's true.
I said we laugh, but it's true. After I said
it. That's why I'm dying. Time for mom's last rites.
Oh, that's fun.
Vaughn, you sick fuck. Can't believe you did that on her death floor.
On her death pallet. On her death pallet. Sometimes lays a pallet down on there on the floor because it's comfortable.
That bitch didn't invite me to the sleepover.
No, but it was a layup.
I'll show her.
Boop.
Bible says an eye for an eye. Vaughn says a stroke for a stroke.
So come here and let me give you that poke poke.
I'm only trying to lose weight. It's going to be hard because copying the YouTubers and videos of certain food takes the hotness of it now. The last moment. That's hot.
Dude, if I was in a point where I had to eat Dollar Tree food, I'm just ending it.
She, ouch. I don't know if y'all caught it or not, but when she first pulled out that Sunny D, she put it to the camera and she went, orange juice.
Adjacent.
Is it? Like, barely.
It's orange.
It is colored orange.
Oh, fuck me, man.
Because I remember growing up, and I was like, why did my parents never buy me Sunny D? Like, that's just orange juice. And then I became an adult and looked at the side. I'm like, oh.
Oh, it's just sugar.
That's why.
Okay.
Because I would drink it and bite people.
I believe, Lady Starfire, that it's like American-style Chinese food from the Dollar General. It's like...
It is
like fried rice and like chicken, probably.
Yeah, it's one of those microwave. You microwave the shit all together, and it's probably gross. Thank you, Hooves, for the $2 super. As we listen to Billy stuffing his jowls,
it was a cheese stick.
Wait a minute, hold on. What kind of cheese stick are we talking about here?
I think it's Sargento.
Oh shit! No Lucrin.
No, Sargento.
Yeah.
Should get you some of that Lucrin.
It's the best. It's
for poor people.
Cobes loves that shit.
No way.
Exactly. Cobes,
yeah, only the best for Cobes.
No, he's poor and he gets the worst.
What are you talking about? He's not poor.
He's pretty poor.
Yeah, you're right.
He's getting evicted currently.
I mean, that's not because of non-payment.
Because he got the cheapest crack whore he could find.
It always goes back to him being poor. God damn it.
If someone is yelling, if they made a fake YouTube.
Wait a minute. Am I okay? So, like, she shit on stream before and acted like it was totally fine, didn't even really mention it. And then there's like this little tiny burp that escapes, and she's like, oh, excuse me. Like, at this point, once you shit on stream, I think all the nice.
I think you're done. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, why are we wasting our time here?
they're telling the truth? How do you find out someone's lying about something? Are they yelling or whispering? If someone is yelling at you saying it's not me, does it mean they're lying? Yelling fragilely occurs when an individual is excited, delight, surprise, or in pain. Yelling may be inspired by personal victory or loss. What? Crystal Grandma from beyond the grave. Google the devil, help me. Whoever this is, you need to stop bullying me. It won't work.
Google the devil, help me.
I don't know what's going on.
15 amen.
Get you in trouble to let you know. Gatorade and vodka, rehydrate and get truck in. Okay, you need help, but I don't act like that. Yes, bully free zone. Yes, you're right.
Is that a micro nap?
That's not funny. If someone dies, it's not funny to fake their death. My grandma would say beyond the grave. She wouldn't say
you that hear that, Grampy?
I want to let you know.
Well, probably wanted. Not.
It's me, Grandma. Believe me. No, I'm not.
Wait a minute. Did that say if someone dies, it's not funny to spoof them or whatever? What hold exactly on, there was, did that say?
It was a quote, wasn't there? Let's see. Let's get her exact words here.
That's not funny. If someone dies, it's not funny to fake their death. My-
if someone dies, is nice. It's not funny to fake their death. Well, Grampy, that was not funny then.
Stop that, Grampy.
Come back.
Yeah, Lady Starfire. Great, great fucking music on Wax Trax. Great.
Abortions are us. We're better than coat hangers, folks.
Fuck. That's, I mean, this is really some Shakespearean shit we're witnessing here, everyone. Like, in the annals of literature. Or I guess maybe in the annals.
Yeah. If someone dies, don't fake their death.
Well, not necessarily. If someone dies, it's not funny to fake their death. Could be lucrative.
Could be Lucran.
I mean, I'm sure there's some steps before profit, but we'll worry about that when we get there. Oh, fuck. All right, folks. It's about that time.
Oh, let's go overtime. It'll be fine.
All right. We'll go 4 more minutes. That'll be overtime, right?
Two more hours.
I've tricked him into thinking that finishing the show with the actual time is overtime.
My grandma would say beyond the grave. She wouldn't say that word at all to let you know. She won it. It's me, Grandma. Believe me. No, I'm not. Fake people making a YouTube account when I block you, keep coming back again and again and again. It won't work. It's all fake. Hey, Peter Popoff, can you do a prayer that my grandma leaves me alone right now on YouTube Live? It's not hurt someone else.
Why is she bringing up the miracle spring water guy from the like paid programming when I was in high school?
I think he's probably in her chat.
Fucking Peter Popoff made it. I'm glad he evaded all those legal troubles. Show up in her chat. That's good shit.
Praying that now. Hey, Kevin Barry, can you pray? I'm on YouTube Live. People are bullying me, harassing me, pretend they're my grandma, who's already dead and deceased. Rest her soul. Fly high with the angels. They leave me alone right now. But that's Kevin Barry from My Hope Church.
Please don't show him on the screen.
Yeah, let's see all of his contact information.
Jesus Christ.
She's such a fucking loser, man. Oh my God. Can you imagine, like, being, like, whether you had a choice or not, being somewhat, like, close
associated with this person?
Yeah.
And you're like, and then it's like randomly showing you on, like, the internet while also doing the weirdest, most weird fuck shit, and then like pissing off Marty intentionally. And then, dude, did you see the one where she's at the restaurant at the Burger King and the Burger King lady goes, who the fuck is Marty? Like, why is Marty calling? Like, who the fuck is Marty? And then she doesn't move. She just starts rating candy still. I was like, does she not know what's going on here?
Oh my God, man.
And every candy she got, she rated a 10.
This is a 10. Did Leslie rank any Mountain Dews?
You know, he ranked some candy too, but then he did it wrong.
Well, according, he doesn't understand ranking. So
according to fucking Crystal over here, that's not how you rank things.
Have you ever seen the way Perry ranks stuff?
Oh, the 5-star and or the 5 star rating and then 1 out of 10 rating.
Yes. It's a 7-2 star. The fuck does that even mean?
Yeah, what the fuck is that?
Yeah, he was doing it based on all the fish sandwiches the other day.
That's just that they made him go back. That's just the way he used to rate everything that he would rate.
I like Perry streams, it's a lot of fun.
Well, it's about to be 9 o'clock, so how do we rate this stream? Is it like
I'd say it's a
2 stars?
A 3-2 star.
3 2-stars?
3 2-star.
I can live with that. What do you got,
Millie? That's also not how the math works. Fucking. I'm gonna give like a 4 and a 2-star.
Chubb gives it a 5 out of 7. Look, we got a 9-11.
That's very generous of both of them, even though I think high end might mean something different.
Nah, certainly not a national tragedy or anything like that. Like you know,
yeah, that was the day drag was born. That was fucking terrible.
Yeah, that's definitely the worst thing that's ever happened on 9/11.
We got a 2.5 out of 10. I appreciate the consideration of putting that 0.5 in there.
I send us a very similar text to drag every year on his birthday. It basically goes like. On this day, a national tragedy has occurred. Also, some planes hit some buildings.
I think that was my lead-in when I roasted him.
Oh, shit. We got 3 Mr. Blue for You stars.
Oh, fuck. I don't want any of them stars.
I think one of us has to produce, like, some stuff.
Puppet fucks.
Yeah.
Like, can you even give a Mr. Blue for You star without going da 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 dum?
No, different hey, Mr. Blue. Mark
no, Rose. I understand, but you know.
You really do not like him, do you?
Me? I like him quite a bit. I
you like Mr. Blue for You?
Isn't he the one that does the puppet show?
He does the puppet fucking, not the puppet show.
That's a puppet show. I love the puppet show.
I feel like a puppet show like needs like some sort of like structure, not just they fuck.
Well, what's a donkey show?
And it's terrifying.
But they fuck. Or some simile thereof.
3 revs of a possible shanty.
That's kind of low, but I'll take it.
You could fit lots of revs in a shanty.
Right. Well, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but we got 2 different Mark Ruffalos. We got a 3 and a 5 Mark Ruffalos.
Oh, wow. That's so very considerate.
I mean, what better way to go out than on that? Lamort, who is Mr. Blue for You? I think you should type Mr. Blue for You into YouTube. And
I 100% recommend not doing that.
You'll know Millie doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about. Watch when you look at the teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like 2 Italys fighting.
He's not hard to find on YouTube. Go check him out if you want to see some.
Unfortunately, he's not.
He's really not. If you want to see the antics of his very horny puppets, then go check him out. It's a good time had by all, except for
the puppets.
Well, yeah, and him.
He also has lots of watches.
On his neck.
Yeah, way too many watches. Not a single one on his hand.
He wears them like necklaces, for fuck's sake.
And like, he has like 7 coffee makers.
And I guarantee you none of them work, just like the watches. Mm.
Yeah, I feel like he just keeps on buying replacements when they break, instead of like this one just needed a filter or something.
Fuck a battery. Whole new watch time.
Yeah.
Because Mr. Blue for You's got it like that. Don't worry about it. All right, folks.
What time it is.
He fuck.
Hey, do you mind if I give a plug real quick before we check?
Plug away.
I almost hit end stream.
If you enjoy either Hooves or me, please join us, Widow's Son, on Fridays. If you're not subscribed, fix that. Come and join the silliness and
dancing
on Fridays at 5 Pacific.
That's Pacific, folks.
Specific.
Specifically Pacific.
That too.
And also, just doing a little this isn't that, so make sure we get everything done we needed to before we end the show. An obligatory...
I'm gonna run over little kids.
All right. Good night, folks.